Excuse me.
Okay, so all those on the Telegram group have seen the link for this multilingual SVG. So I don't know if you saw how to choose the language here at the bottom of the comments and say go. This one SVG file changes its the text changes. And if you use this SVG file in your home language, based on the home language setting, it will automatically choose that language content. But you can also specify which language to use by using in the file type. You can say lang equal to whatever language, it will still show. Now this is useful in some cases, but may not work in all cases. Can you think of the problems that this will cause? When this will not work? What's the advantage of this? Advantage is you have a single file with multiple instead of having lots of things. Disadvantage is it's not easy to edit this. But right now there is a tool being made by, I don't know if you know, Niharika.
Cool.
So they are working on a tool to make all SVGs editable into automatically into multilingual. But it has some well-known drawbacks. One is, what if the text goes from right to left and you put your text next to that? Will the layout get affected? Probably it will get affected. Another is, translations may not be the same length as the original, so it may not. But there are some situations where it really helps to put this. So we can see an example of how this is made. So the simplest, for doing this, you can't do it in Inkscape. You have to learn to edit the SVG file. So all of you know that SVG file is a text file and it is actually an XML file. So I have downloaded this multilingual SVG example. And if you go to the example, so there is all kinds of metadata and all that, don't bother about it. So then you will find one node where the text exists. And all the text tags, so this is the text tag starting, text tag ending. And here there is a thing saying system language equal to DE. And above it there is a switch tag with a unique ID, and then there is a closing switch tag. So if you see within this, there are multiple text blocks. One for English, one for German, all of them have the same, the rest of the parameters are the same. And then at the end of it, there is a switch tag. So that's it. So what I have decided is, let us try working on some pre-existing SVG. So there is a Portuguese SVG file called Life Cycle of the Malaria Parasite. I have downloaded this SVG file and I have opened it and I have created a copy called same Life Cycle of Malaria Parasite multilingual. And in that, what I did is I searched for the text tag and I added a switch tag before that. Actually, we don't need this ID even. And since it was original was Portuguese, I kept added a system language equal to Portuguese. I duplicated this section and added an extra block with EN, and then I changed the text. Here it says cycle of the parasite in Portuguese. I wrote life cycle of malaria parasite. And then I closed the switch tag. And I saved this file and I uploaded it as a new SVG file, but I gave it a name saying life cycle of malaria parasite multilingual. And now automatically there is a drop down appearing here. So if I choose English, only the title is in English, rest is still non translated. So if I choose Spanish and say go, it puts the Spanish title at the top. So, we can complete this exercise. maybe if any of you are interested, you can try adding Punjabi sections into this, so we can make this particular file multilingual.
Don't you think we should do this one by one?
Yeah, we could do it one by one. So I'm going to
do the.
Yeah, yeah, no, it does.
You have to edit
the same file, otherwise you will be copying multiple.
No, different files. Different images.
So you can try it, yeah.
So where are these labels section model?
So you just search, you can go through the SVG file and search for Control F text. So if you go for text notes, somewhere here, so it has all the properties, the fonts and all that, and then here it says, so it says sexual stage. So this part, so this tag, now I need to put in a English section. So in fact I can take this into the old switch, I can move the switch statement to encompass this other text as well. And what do I do? Here this is the original system language, Portuguese. So I write system language equal to Portuguese and I copy this whole section. And I make one more section where the system language is EN. So whatever
switches for like online.
So you just look for text tags, duplicate them, add a new system language switch.
My question is, does the switch one and the end of switch one work for one entire language? Yeah, just one sentence for each.
So you can put multiple switches or one single big switch. If all the text tags can be collated into one block, you can do it.
You can do it all in one block.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Work, we'll add one.
Exactly. So just experiment. Let's see what we figure out. I believe you can do it in one switch. You don't need multiple switches. Okay. So this one is I'm making it English.
Language.
Yeah.
There were six languages.
Yeah.
So, if somebody knows the right to left language, this is going to be an interesting test. Try out right to left on this and see how badly it looks.